While some of the Powerstroke engines, like the 6-liter and 6.4-liter, have earned a reputation for being pretty horrible, the earlier 7.3-liter Powerstroke has earned a reputation as being one of the most reliable diesel engines ever. It might be an underpowered dinosaur by today's standards, but the 7.3 is still a pretty interesting engine. So let's dive in and discuss everything you need to know about the 7.3-liter Powerstroke. To stay ahead of GM and gain some ground on Dodge, Ford released the Powerstroke in 1994. While it wasn't anything incredibly special at the time, it was far better than anything GM had to offer, and it was pretty comparable to the 5.9 Cummins. Starting out with the basics, it's a 7.3 liter or 444 cubic inch V8 with direct injection, a beefy cast iron block, cast iron heads, an overhead two-valve per cylinder design, and it featured a fixed geometry turbocharger, which we'll talk a little bit more in depth about later in the video. Internally, the 7.3 is incredibly simple and it really doesn't feature anything special or unique. Bore measures at 4.11 inches with a stroke at 4.18 inches, and depending on the year, it either had a Garrett TP38 fixed geometry turbocharger or a Garrett GTP38. Power ranges anywhere from 210 horsepower up to 275 horsepower and 425 pound-feet up to 525 pound-feet. What's particularly interesting about the 7.3 Powerstroke is that it didn't really have any emission systems other than a catalytic converter. And as you might already know, modern diesels are really choked down with emission systems and they really, really restrict them. So the fact that it didn't have any emission systems is a really big plus. Despite the lack of emission systems other than a catalytic converter, the 7.3 was somehow more emissions friendly than Dodge's 5.9 Cummins at the time, while also producing more horsepower and more torque upon initial release. With parts like forged connecting rods and 6 bolts per head cylinder, it was pretty obvious that the 7.3 was a really stout engine when Ford initially released it. The only thing which was a concern when it first came out was the new HEUI system, but that's since proved itself to be pretty reliable. Compared to diesels of today, 210 horsepower and 425 pound-feet is comically weak. There's really no getting around it. But at the time that it came out, it was a solid number, and it was actually more powerful than anything GM or Dodge offered when the 7.3 was initially released. One of the most important design features that made the 7.3 as strong as it is are the 6 12mm head bolts. Now for reference, you can look at the older 7.3 IDI engines, which only had 5 head bolts per cylinder, or even worse, you can go forwards and look at the 6-liter Powerstroke, which only had 4 head bolts per cylinder. As you can probably imagine, 6 head bolts per cylinder gives the 7.3 a lot of clamping force, and it's able to withstand a lot of boost pressure, upwards of 40 psi before the stock head gaskets become an issue. Now having 6 bolts per head cylinder also means that you have even more clamping force when you go to either aftermarket head bolts or aftermarket head studs. Speaking of things which make the 7.3 pretty reliable, we have to talk about the connecting rods. For the most part, the 94.5 to 2000 models have forged connecting rods, and the 01 to 03 are a mix between powdered metal and forged connecting rods. Either way you go, both connecting rods are pretty strong, with the forged connecting rods holding up to around 600 wheel horsepower and the powdered metal connecting rods holding up to around 500 wheel horsepower. All the advancements on the 7.3 engine, the direct injection system is arguably the most important. The HUI injectors came from Caterpillar, who leased the technology to Navistar to use for the 7.3 Powerstroke, as well as some other Navistar engines. The hydraulically actuated electronically controlled unit injector, also known as HEUI, is a system which revolves around a high pressure oil pump sending oil volume through oil rails integrated into the engine's cylinder heads. This allows oil to feed the top side of each injector. The high pressure oil pump is designed to get oil into the rails within the heads. Once oil exits the high pressure oil pump, injector pressure regulator pressurizes it as high as 3000 psi. From there, the pressurized oil acts on an intensifier piston, compressing the fuel below it and resulting in injecting pressure as high as 21,000 psi inside the cylinder. Moving on to the turbochargers, we have 3 different turbochargers featured throughout the 7.3 Powerstroke's lifespan. First up is the non-wastegated TP38 with a 1.15 AR housing, which was used on the earlier non-intercooled models. In 1999, an air-to-air intercooler was added, and it still used the TP38 turbocharger, but it came with a tighter 0.84 AR housing and a wastegate. After that, the GTP38 was used, which had a larger exhaust housing and a much larger wastegate. Now, although each version of this turbocharger is slightly better, they all used a 60mm inducer and a 70mm exducer. Although these simple fixed geometry turbochargers can't really make as much low power and high-end power as something like a variable geometry turbocharger found on modern diesels, the fixed geometry design is super reliable, and there's very few things that can actually go wrong with a fixed geometry turbocharger, especially compared to a variable geometry turbocharger, which can have all sorts of issues in the long run. Now, of course, compared to modern turbochargers, the TP38 and GTP38 are pretty inefficient, and they really don't have all that much power potential, but if you just want something super reliable, they're a pretty decent turbocharger. Speaking of things that make the 7.3 Powerstroke as reliable as it is, we have to talk about the fact that it's underpowered. Let's be real, it's kind of hard to break anything when you're making 210 horsepower out of a 7.3 liter engine. Now realistically, torque is what breaks things and not horsepower, but the point still stands. The 7.3 Powerstroke is pretty underpowered for such a large diesel engine. Now while that might make the Ford trucks that it powers incredibly slow or not able to tow all that much, it makes them really, really reliable in the long run. Now that being said, the 7.3 is still really reliable once you turn the power up, either by adding more boost or sticking on a different turbocharger or just cranking up the fuel or whatever you're doing. The 7.3 is still going to be pretty reliable even when it's making double the factory power output. Other things like the 6 head bolts per cylinder, long lasting injectors, super simple internal design, strong bottom end components, and fixed geometry turbocharger just really make the 7.3 Powerstroke the simplest and arguably the most reliable Powerstroke ever built. Now it's also important to note that the 7.3 Powerstroke was around at a time when manual transmissions in diesel trucks were actually fairly common, and that's just another thing that made these Ford trucks so reliable. Automatic transmissions might be nice and convenient, but realistically they're not going to be as reliable as a manual transmission, although pretty much all modern diesels have moved to automatic transmissions just for ease of use. Now after years with the 7.3 Powerstroke being super reliable and really great for Ford, eventually it wasn't really able to keep up with emission standards because it wasn't designed for emission systems in the first place. So Ford and Navistar eventually moved to the 6-liter Powerstroke, which was a pretty problematic engine, which we've covered in our 6-liter versus 7.3-liter Powerstroke video, which I highly recommend you watch. So that's pretty much all I have for you guys today. 7.3 Powerstroke is a really basic and really simple engine, but it's ultimately really reliable and it has a really big cult following. If there's anything I missed or anything you want to add, be sure to drop a comment down below and let me know. While you're down there, hit the thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos. This is Bryce with Dust Runners Automotive Journal, signing off.